Hello, I'm Dean the Vaping Biker. Today we've got a quite an exciting little one, which is kind of more for the kitsch value than anything else. But today we're going to be looking at these bad boys, the Zen Pipe and the Pipe 3 from Vape Only. Let's go and have a little look around these little bad boys, shall we?
Come on then!
So here we are. This is the packaging for the Zen Pipe, but this one and in fact the Pipe 3 are exactly the same. But obviously the Pipe 3, as you'll see, has got a little gold thing going on there. It's shorter. But yes, the packaging and the contents are pretty much the same. So, just for today, I've stuck this one in here so you can have a look at it. Now, this is a massive, massive box. As you can see, I can barely get it under camera. If we open this bad boy up, you do get a little kind of manwell up in the top there, and you do get the pipe in all its glory inside there, which I think is absolutely lovely. It's a really nice unboxing experience, and I'm really, really happy with that. So once we get the pipe out, and we'll look at that in a moment, you can then take the top off, and what you've got here, that's an extra couple of coils, which we'll talk about shortly. But in here we have a charger. We've got 225Rs going on in here, and in this one it does actually have a little stand that you can stand your pipe up on top of, which worked great for the Zen Pipe, a little bit iffy for the Pipe 3, but yes, you get them in both. But I think that's a nice little touch, to be honest with you. And here we have the Zen Pipe itself, and I think that really does look classy as you like, and I think that's really, really very cool. It does look, it feels like a pipe, and it feels rather great. Now, this is old technology. There's no getting away from that. This really is, but it's done oh so well. It really, really is. So if I take out the top there of the pipe stem, what we've got is the atomiser, and we'll look at those atomisers in a little bit more detail and a little bit more close up in a moment. But when we have got the atomiser on the top there, you can unscrew that to replace the whole atomiser, like so. And it's a super old school fitting going on there. So yeah, it's the ego fitting we used to use back in the day. But yeah, that's how you get the atomiser on and off. Got a little bit of juice all over my handy pandies there. You do have a little hole at the top there, and like I say, we'll check that out in a minute. But once that's on, then your pipe stem goes back on, and it stays on there with a couple of O-rings going on right there, and that's fine and dandy. Now then, the battery itself, it all comes into this top cap here. That has a little bit of an unscrew, and then your battery goes in, top facing up. And that's it. You do have a spring going on down the bottom there. I don't know if you can just about see that. And this is what I mean about going for really kind of old school kind of stuff, you know. I would have imagined they could have even put a 26650 in here if they'd wanted to. But no, not much else. But what you do is you're popping your battery in there. You're then on the underside here, you can see that you do have these little tabs going off either side. They go into the little slots going in on the top there, and then you just screw down this so it's nice and snug, and then it flashes to let you know that it's made a contact. Then when you vape, let me see if I can do this one. You can see that bad boy lights up on the top of that one as well. But that's it. That's the pipe. Now, the Pipe 3, this is the Zen, by the way, as I just mentioned. The Pipe 3 is fairly similar. It works in exactly the same way, apart from it takes an 18350, and this whole top cap does come off. Now, you do get the 18350s in the pack as well, and the ones that you get for these are Vape Only INR 18350s, 3.7 volt, 1300 mAh, 15 amps, so you're not going to be sub-ohming with any of these anyway, but it works in exactly the same way. I do prefer this connection on the top, in all honesty, I'm not going to lie, but it just seems to be a little bit tighter and a little bit firmer. But it does have this big old gold kind of looking thing going on the top there and there. So it's going to be dependent on whether that's your sort of bag or not, really. But it lights up in exactly the same way as the other one did. So it does exactly the same thing to replicate that kind of pipe smoking kind of thing. And this one is a little bit more of a normal kind of pipe size that you would kind of pat down with your finger or whatever else, or at least kind of stop the air on a normal pipe. Now the air on these is coming through under here, And it does a pretty reasonable job, to be honest with you. It gives you a certain restriction, which is great. But if you do want to tighten things up a little bit more, you can pop your finger over that a little bit. But no, that's it when it comes to the pipes. Now let's look at the coils. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to unpackage a brand new vaporizer for you. So it's basically the atomizer going on here, and that just helps me explain what's going on with the coils a little bit easier. But if we take that bad boy open, like so, I mean, this is old school as you like. It really, really is. But to fill it up and have access to your coils, what you're doing is you're unscrewing the top section away from the base and giving that a bit of a pull. And you've got, when you're filling up down the side of the glass there, and obviously stopping when you get to the top of the chimney tube there itself. Now you'll see that this is the coil that we've got going on. Hopefully, let's see if I can make sure that this is in focus. This is the coil that we've got going on. And this little wicking slot that you'll see going on here is all important, because the original one, and let me get you this one out here, because this is one of the original ones that I had. And this was tiny. Look at the size of those wick holes. They are minuscule. They really are dinky as you like. Hang on, what have we done with the other one? There it is. And so you can see that there is an absolute improvement going on right there. This being the old one and this being the new one. So yeah, with this new one, I've had absolutely no issues at all with gentle vaping with a higher VG. Now these are both 0.7. You might be able to see that just on the side there. So these are both 0.7 coils. And to take them out, all you're going to do is unscrew it. I can't grab hold of it at the moment because I can't grip it. But yeah, you're just unscrewing that and then screwing that bad boy right back in there. But yeah, the new coils, much, much better. But that's it. That's how it works. So you juice up the coils. I pop a little drip or two of juice down there. Fill up your tank. Screw that on like so. And then once you've got that nice and tight, then that can go into your pipe and away you go. So that was the tour around the Zen Pipe and showing you off the Pipe 3 as well. And yeah, it's they're a thing, aren't they? Now then, the stand that I was sort of showing there, basically your pipe just sits in there and boom, job done. Now with the Pipe 3, because of the shape of it, it doesn't really sit overly comfortably and it wants to kind of slip off. So you have to kind of precariously balance it on top of that one. But it does work. It does work as long as you don't mess about with it too much. Now obviously these don't stand by themselves, so you do need to have that stand unless you've got it in your hand. But I have laid this down and not had any significant leaking or anything like that to worry about. Now then, how does it perform? Well, it's not a killer. It's not going to blow your friends away with cloud production. And essentially where we're at when it comes to the draw with this is you have a kind of a very loose mouth to lung or a very tight lung. So you can, you know, you can mouth to lung it, but and you get a little bit more if you do lung hit it straight away. But you're not going to buy this if you want clouds. To be honest with you, where you've got the atomizer going on there and the distance that the vape has to travel to get into your mouth from that position down the bottom where that coil is huge. So you're going to have a cool vape. And it's going to be something that isn't super flavourful, to be honest with you. It's not crazy flavourful. I think a kind of a place for this would be for someone with high nic. I mean, I've been trying using nic salts through this, or Dr. Salts rather, e-liquid. But to be honest, I've gone just with the normal 3 milligram stuff, just because I can vape away on it and have a jolly good time and feel super posh whilst doing it. Now, one thing that does happen with this, from time to time, you go to take a vape on it, and I bet it won't do it now. There you go, see that flashing? No idea why that happens. And I asked the company as well, and I didn't get an answer. And it's flashing. And I don't really get why that. I don't really understand it. I don't know why it does it. I thought that it might have to do with the contact not being too clever. And then when I got these new atomizers, I put those in and that seemed to fix it. But it still does it from time to time. Although they're nothing. So I don't know. I don't know. Now then, price wise, this is one of those things that is a bit of a sod to find, to be honest with you. I'm having a little look online now, and I can't really find anywhere. Heaven's Gifts have it on there on Google, but it's not actually on their website. And so actually finding them for sale is a bloody nightmare. So, you know, this is going to take some Google foo from anyone. If I do find anything from a reputable supplier or someone who looks like they might be, I don't know, then I'll put a link down below. Otherwise, it's going to take some Google foo to try and find this bad boy. I will definitely put the link down below for the Vape Only website, so you can go and check that bad boy out. But no, I mean, I think these are old school technology, and they work as an old school kind of product did from maybe 4 years ago, something like that. And so, you know, you wouldn't expect, or you shouldn't expect, kind of really good, strong performance with it. I've got a bug. I'm sure I've seen it somewhere, but even on the Vape Only website, it doesn't say how much they are. So, don't know. I honestly don't know. So, it is what it is. But when it comes to the styling of them, I think they look lovely. These are rosewood, so I think that's very nice. I believe the gold stuff is actually brass. I think on this one, it's a little bit on the tacky side. On this one, it is kind of less in your face, which I think is good. Like I said in the up close, I do much prefer the way this contact goes down on this one. But even this one will have a little flashing moment from time to time. But there you go. So, interesting fact for you. I don't know if you know this, but you know how people say about kind of, oh, we didn't have plague competitions when we were smoking? Well, no, but pipe smokers for many years have had competitions where you get a bunch of pipe smokers in a room that have a very sort of, that have a measured out bit of tobacco. Then it'd all be down to how they packed it, and then it would be a competition on who could keep that tobacco alight the longest. So there has been competition in pipe smoking for many years before vaping came on the scene. So there you go, a little bit of a useless fact that you can take away with you there. But all in all, I don't know how much these are. I have no idea. I can't find the cost of them. But do I think that these are cool and funky if you can get them cheap enough? Fucking right I do. I think they're kitschy, I think they're fun, and they make you feel like a sir, and people will always take you more seriously if you point at things with a pipe. Simple as. Anyway, that's about all I can tell you on these bad boys. It's absolute. In fact, let's try and do a sign off with both of them, shall we? Thank you very much for watching. I will pop my little subscribe thing down there, and I'll pop a couple of videos there and there. See? Pointing. Have it launched!